Keywords Studios has unveiled yet another new acquisition this morning, GameSim. For more details, I've got Andrew Day, Keywords Chief Executive, with me on Skype. Andrew, morning to you. Welcome.
Morning, Andrew.
Andrew, tell me a bit more about GameSim. Quite a significant acquisition, this one.
Yeah, I believe so. Not so much because of the scale of the acquisition, because it fits into our sweet spot. We're paying about $4.8 million for the company. But what is significant about it is that it's in a new line of business for us. This is our first step into the field of software engineering delivered as a service to our game clients. And it's basically the intention is to build an engineering service line much along the lines that we've built our art services business, which has continued to perform very strongly. So the first of many to come, I hope, Andrew.
In terms of some of the projects and clients that they've been working on, would they be names familiar to us?
Yeah, indeed. I mean, so Electronic Arts is a long-established client of theirs. They also work with companies like Zynga. But interestingly enough, this business also works with the Department of Defense in the US, where it's using game technology for simulation and training purposes. So it's quite interesting. It's a business that that brings a lot of expertise with it to Keywords that we can obviously leverage for the benefit of our wider client base around the world.
So it's a solid business here. They're revenue generating as well?
Yep. They're nicely profitable. We haven't actually disclosed the profitability figures on this acquisition, but as you might expect with Keywords, we expect this business to be performing at the levels of profit that we as an overall group achieve, so around about 15% net margin. But it's a business with revenues of $4.1 million last year and growing this year and beyond. So I think it's going to fit very nicely within the general financial metrics that we look for as a group.
And speaking of businesses which fit very nicely, it's only been, five, 7 days since you announced the acquisition of XLOC as well.
Yes, sorry about that. We keep them flowing fast. XLOC's another very interesting business. It is a technology play, really. It has produced over many years the industry-leading specialist content management system for managing textual assets within video games. And it's used by many large video game companies for precisely that purpose, and is highly sort of integrated within their environments and particularly into their game engines. So for us, the opportunity is to further integrate that with our downstream work, where we're actually managing the translations themselves. And I think, frankly speaking, it all starts to join up, the sort of expertise and the scale of the GameSim business together with XLOX provides us with quite a sort of technical competency, which we can bring to bear throughout all of our service lines.
I saw spot these latest two acquisitions, both of them are US-based.
Yep.
Is the US an increasing focus for you?
Not particularly. I mean, these businesses were chosen because of their particular expertise. They just happen to be in the US. I mean, obviously, the US is the second largest market for video games worldwide, so it's not surprising that there are a number of the businesses that would be of interest for us in the US. But it's not a specific focus of ours, geographically speaking. In fact, I'm sitting here in Tokyo, and a lot of our development of late has been in the Asian region, and we continue to grow fast in this space. China, of course, being the world's largest single video game market. So, it's nothing really to do with the geography itself.
I wish you all the very best, Andrew. Good to catch up with you as always. Thanks very much indeed.
Thanks a lot, Andrew. Nice speaking to you.